Don't forget to check out my Patreon link in the description down below, where we do exclusive content for videos that get blocked on YouTube, like Level Up Project 1, 2, and 3, Twice Sees the Light, Blackpink House, 80s Treasure Film, Blackpink's documentary. Tons of blocked performances are on there as well, and certain tours such as Redmare, Red Room, Twice Lights, Twice Land, the Blackpink The Show online concert, Shiny World 4, and tons of Knowing Bro episodes, and so much more. Link in description down below. Hey guys, Angie here, and today we have Lily's film, The Movie. I actually haven't seen any spoilers, thankfully, for this. I was contemplating on reacting to it because I didn't know what it was. I don't know if it's a dance thing or if it's a mini film type thing. I don't really know what it is. When I saw the title, I didn't think it was dancing, so I kind of just was like, maybe I'll watch it on my own, because I try to react to her dancing things. But other people are reacting to it, so my mind's thinking maybe there's dancing or something in it. And no, I'm not reacting to it because everyone else is reacting to it. I'll just, you know, it's hard to look and see if it's worth reacting to because I don't know what it is. So because other people are, I'm guessing maybe there is some like form of dance or something, and so I'm going to react to it because she does like, what are they called, vlogs and stuff, like little vloggy edited things, you know. So I was like, maybe it's one of those. I was confused. I'm still kind of confused because I haven't seen anything from it, but I guess that's the element of reacting, is you just don't know. So let's see. We're being fed so well, Blinks, the past year with Rose Solo, which is on Patreon because of the concert gets blocked, so I reacted to the whole concert on there. Now we have Lisa's content. Is it like a music video? Okay. Okay, Lisa. Okay, already cool. What's the song? The Court is Cheshire. Music by Destiny Rogers Tomboy. Okay, so it's like a cinema. It's like a, not, I don't know, contemporary, but it's like a storytelling dance. Okay, I like this. Like these little synchronized. Hey, this is cool. This is different. I like how she mouthed it. Okay, Lisa always giving me these good songs to add to my playlist. Oh, this is really cool. It's different from her other ones. Okay, so different from her other ones. Her other dances are solo in one location usually, like on the rooftop and everything, or in the dance practice room. This is really cool. Okay, go off, Lisa. And it's a little more simplistic, but it has like this story to it. I love the control. Oh, that was, I love that. Okay, it's my favorite part. Oh, smooth. Hey, that was different. Okay. Lisa. Lisa. Okay, Lisa. When I first saw Lisa, like 3 years ago, 2018, I thought she was like really girly, really like feminine, like, and she is, but she has this tomboy. I know that's like a hated word nowadays, even though it's the name of the song. I know like people really hate that term now, but I guess it's you. Because I don't like when people say masculine towards a female, it can come off as insulting. I don't know, whatever, you know, I'm just speaking my mind. She has more masculine vibes than you would first think. Like, she has her style, even her mannerisms. She kind of has this edge to her which neither are bad or good. I don't think feminine girls are bad or masculine girls are bad. I think both are beautiful. I think in the middle is beautiful. I feel like she's low-key more in the middle, but when she moves and dances, she can emit like a feminine side, which is what she's about to do, like more sensual side. Like she's so versatile with her looks, her personality even. She has like, I mean, everyone has different personalities and stuff, but Lisa just has such an interesting, like you never know what you're gonna get with her. Like right here, a little more tomboyish and then more sensual, typical feminine kind of feel. I like the song. Hey, the backup dancers too, so in sync. Hey. Born skinny, bitch. Oh, that was so. Angie getting more attracted to Lisa every release, every release. Oh, Lisa, please. Okay. The way her ponytail moved with the beat, that was so cool. The transition there was really cool. Lisa always gets down, man. That girl took off the mask. What does that mean? And what is the what? I'm kind of confused on the video story, though. Can't lie. I don't know cards, though, so I think that's gonna sadly. That's so funny because in 24/365, it's not gonna be out yet because this is new, so it's gonna be out first. But in the sixth episode, I just watched it yesterday. They were playing with the cards, like the magic guy came and did the card thing. So ironically, suited for me right now. Wait, okay, what's happening? She came and like one of the girls took off their mask, and now she's leaving as the smoke fumes the room. Oh, I have to look at the comments. I'm so confused. But I love this. It's a mini, it's her own music video. It's a mini music video. I want to know, do I was looking at the names. BTS, oh, behind the scenes. I was like, what? What was I gonna ask? Oh, when like Lisa, who's very famous, when they do these videos, do they have to ask like Destiny Rogers? Do they have to ask her for permission to use her song? Because if not, Destiny Rogers, her company, whoever she works with would copyright this and Destiny would get all the money. Which I mean, I personally think that's fair. I think if you're gonna use the whole song, then yeah, Destiny Rogers should probably get paid for it. But I know you can contact people before you use their song, if, like on a project like this, and maybe there's like a deal, like you split it, this profit. So I know you guys probably couldn't answer that because it's, you're not, I think everyone's probably different. Maybe some artists would just do the thing for fun and let the singer get the money. But then I feel like YG, I feel like he would probably like, or whoever is in charge of Lisa's YouTube, because we know they don't really have much control over it. I know like they would probably want profit from this because I mean 7 million views like in one day. I'm a girl's girl. I'm a boss in a man's world. Lisa, talented as always. Most of the comments aren't talking about the video, so if you understand the video more than I do, let me know. I just love the dancing, the cinematography, the choreo, her outfit changes, the song, amazing as always. And yeah, that is it for this video. Guys, check out my Patreon for Blackpink the Show, Blackpink Unknowing Bros, Blackpink House. The second Knowing Bros episode will be coming out soon. I don't know really when, so don't look forward to the second one. I did the most recent Knowing Bros episode because I already seen clips from the original one. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.